Today we are going to try getting a perfect background blur for this highly compressed mobile photo using Snapseed and Lightroom apps. After opening the image in Snapseed, first I'm going to use Tune Image to add contrast and a little bit of saturation. Also details to add structure. I'm going to save this and revert back to the original. Now you need to choose which part of the image is the foreground. It should be easy here as it is the bird and the pole it is sitting on. So using healing tool, I'm gonna brush roughly on those parts to remove them. Don't need to be perfect here as they are going to be blurred anyway. Next, using the lens blur tool, choosing the linear option. Decreasing the transition and scaling down the tool. Moving it to a corner here. Setting the blur strength to 100 and vignette strength to 0. You can notice the corner patch, which I'm going to fix easily with the healing tool. I'm going to repeat the lens blur step again to get more blur. Now, using double exposure, I'm going to add the saved image on top of this and set the opacity to 100. Going to masking screen now. Tapping on this tax icon, view edits, double exposure and brush. Here with the image hidden and brush set at 100, roughly brushing on and around the bird to reveal it. Setting the brush value to 0. Now zooming in as much as possible. This is important to get a precise selection. Brushing on the edges carefully to reveal the image underneath, which is basically a fully blurred image. Taking a lot of time here to get the selection right, as the final look is dependent on how well the selection is made. On second thoughts, I will remove this thing underneath, which is quite distracting. The before and after. Next, I'm going to crop the image using crop tool. Adding vignette with the vintage filter. After these edits, I'm going to export this to Lightroom app to make it look even better. Here in Lightroom, first in light menu, adding whites with a two-finger swipe to make the brightest spots as bright as possible without getting clipped. Same with the black slider for the darkest parts. In the color menu for the HSL sliders. Increasing the saturation of the oranges and the reds to make them pop more. Detail menu now. First, adding sharpening a little to enable the masking slider. Now, dragging the masking slider with two fingers to get a selection mask where the sharpening will be applied. Increasing the sharpening to desired levels. Also, radius and detail sliders, which will pop the subject further. The final result here. Hope you found these tricks useful and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.